Holy crap, we're running late. Oh my god, hold on, let's go to the booth. Hey everybody, good morning, it's time for Video Games with Video James. That's me! I'm Video James, and holy crap, it's been like 2 weeks, guys. I apologize for not streaming last week. We had to leave for Vancouver for the Pro Tour, and I had a whole bunch of stuff to do, mainly cleaning my vehicle. That actually took longer than I thought it would. Hello, everybody! How is everybody doing? Alright. Let's turn that down a little bit. Mangled Pixel with that 23-month resub! Mangled Pixel, thank you so much for your continued support of the channel! Super appreciate it, thank you so much. Oh, you're James! I thought the guy with the hat was James. No. No, it's not. Hey, Rebellious Uno, how's it going? Man, Uno, I miss the sound of your voice. It's so weird. We'll get back to it, though. Sooner or later. Soon the summer will be over, and that other thing that I emailed you about might happen, but... holy crap, I've had a lot going on, so... give me some time on that, and I'll try to make it actually happen. Seem to be lower than normal here. That's a bit better. Ooh, can make my head disappear. Creepy. It's your birthday! Everybody wish Uno a happy birthday. It is Uno's birthday. The happiest of birthdays to Uno. Alright. That's enough of that. Let's turn that down a little bit more. Alright, guys. So here's the deal. We are still in Summer Funner Fest, and today I'm going to do something crazy. Well, hopefully today. We're late, I can't stream as long, but I'm still going to do it, so let's do this. There is a little bit of a problem, but I have a solution. So it is August 6th, I will be streaming this week, next week, and the week after that. And then I'll have a week off for PAX, but then I'll be back. And what we're gonna do for the next little while, Sleeper Awakened with that 5-month resub! Sleeper Awakened, thank you so much for your continued support of the channel! I super appreciate it, thank you so much. Yeah, we're gonna play Dragon Age Inquisition. Now, I have never played a Dragon Age game before. So yeah, I've never played any Dragon Age before, and I'm gonna start with Inquisition, and I've been told that that's completely fine. I have experts on the matter who I have conversed with, mainly Trin. She said go for it, but she said first you should read this article that I'm going to send you a link to, and I think I'm going to do that because Dragon Age Inquisition is very big and is going to take a little while to download. I started downloading it last night when Cam was done. I like VNC'd into the computer at like 11. And then I think the internet stopped working, because when I got here this morning, the internet wasn't working, so... awkward. So it's at 13% right now, and it's like a 25 gigabyte game. So... we have to kill some time before that's done. So for now... yep. Defeated by username Kaiju has it right. We're gonna play James Reads This Article called A Beginner's Guide to All Things Dragon Age. I think it's gonna be good. I think this is gonna be funny. Well, I don't know about funny, but... alright. First things first. This green screen looks a little bad. Player cam. Color. That's a bit better. Alright. Well, I don't think there's voices, because it's... I think it's just like an article that's explaining stuff. But it is quite long, but that's good because we have some time. And it's got pictures. And I think what I'll do is I'll zoom in here. Yeah, there we go. In fact, we could probably even go a little bit more. Oh, yeah. Well, that might be a bit too much. We'll go there. That's fine. All right, so, a beginner's guide to all things Dragon Age. Okay, so a darkspawn is basically an orc, I guess, sure. Hilarious. All right, good news, Dragon Age Inquisition is pretty great. Less good news, being a story-heavy role-playing game, it relies heavily on familiarity with the Dragon Age series' dense lore. Newcomers might be a bit lost at times. Uh-oh! I get the sense that a lot of people who missed the first two games are going to give this one a shot. As well they should. Skipping right to Inquisition is definitely doable, but in order to have the best time, you'll probably want to brush up on your lore front. And that's what I'm here for. Alright, so. Oh yeah, my lower third. This isn't Rocket League. Brushing up on my Dragon's Ages lore. There we go. Alright. Before you start the game, I highly recommend going through the Dragon Age Keep. Oh, okay, what's this? Ooh. What's this do? Sign in. Sign in with your EA account. Wait. Can I sign in with my Origins account? Does that work? Hold on. Don't do that? Alright, well let's go back. Okay. It's a waste of time if you've never played before. Alright. It is a web app that BioWare has set up to guide prospective players through the events of the first two games. As you do the keep, you get to make all the major story-affecting decisions in both games, then import that world state into your Inquisition game. The keep is extremely cool, but paradoxically, it can be hard to follow for someone who doesn't already know a Templar from a Grey Warden. Oh, alright. Well, that makes sense. To help with that, I thought I'd take the time to write an explainer for anyone thinking of picking up the game when it comes out next week. The finished article came out pretty long ago, or pretty long, but hey, the game itself is pretty long, so hopefully you're okay with long. Couple notes. Obviously, this post will include extensive spoilers for both Dragon Age Origins and Dragon Age 2. That said, while I've chosen to highlight some things you'll probably want to know for Dragon Age Inquisition, this post will not contain any direct spoilers for the new game. While this post is intended for newcomers, it's still pretty dense with lore, so it'll probably work just as well as a reference to keep handy as you play through Inquisition. Lastly, I will readily admit that while I'm pretty into Dragon Age, I'm not infallible. So if there's any mistakes in this post, I hope you'll let me know so that I can correct them. Ready? Let's go! Alright. Hi, I'd love to know more about the world of Dragon Age. Can you give me the basics? Why, hello! Sure thing. Let's start with the name of the world we're in. Thedas, or the Das. I'm gonna assume it's the Das. Everything that happens in Dragon Age happens in the Das. Though there are some realms beyond it. It's basically like Middle-earth in Lord of the Rings. Or Tamriel in The Elder Scrolls. Fun fact, the Das was originally shorthand for the D-A-S. Oh, so I was right. The Das. The Das. And the name stuck. Here's the world, I assume. The Das is comprised of a bunch of different nations, but three are more important than the others. There's Feladrin, or Ferelden, I guess Ferelden, to the southeast, which is basically medieval England, where everyone is kind of ugly and dirty and life is pretty cheap. They're ruled by a king and queen. Orlais is west of Ferelden, and is closer to the Renaissance France, where everyone is cultured. The accents are basically French, and the nobles wage war with secrets and subterfuge. Ferelden? Ferelden. Alright. Orlais. Oh, that's Orle? Alright. Orle. They have an empress, though she's currently embroiled in a civil war with her cousin who claims to the right of her claims the right to her throne. And then there's the Teventer Imperium? Teventer? I assume Teventer. Which is to the north and is run by a bunch of powerful power-hungry mages called Magisters who wield unholy magics, own slaves, and are pretty much just huge dicks to everyone. They're led by the Imperial Archon. Alright. There are plenty of other clans and nations and peoples, which we'll get to, but those are the big three. Also of note, historical eras of the Das are broken into several different ages, like the Ancient Age and the Storm Age. The current age and the era containing the events of all three games in the series is the Dragon Age, hence the series title. Alright, got it. So, how do those three nations fit into the series? Well, the first game in the series, 2009 Dragon Age Origins, takes place in... Wait, how'd you say it again? Ferelden? Yeah. Took place in Ferelden. You sometimes meet people from Teventar or Orle. But the game itself was mostly just concerned with the fate of Ferelden. The king dies at the start of the game, and a lot of the political maneuvering in the story is concerned with naming his successor. The second game, Dragon Age 2, takes place in a city called Kirkwall, which is located in a rulerless region north of Ferelden called the Free Marches. You play as a man or woman named Hawk, and while you run into a lot of people from various different nations over the course of the story, you mostly just stay in Kirkwall, which was one of the reasons the sequel was so poorly received by BioWare fans. Alright, good to know. Uh-oh. Let's get on to the mages, the elves, the dwarves, and all that. It sounds pretty familiar. It is, and it also isn't. Before we dive in, here's a good thing to keep in mind. Nothing in the Das is simple. Pretty much every race, class, nation, and organization has some sort of internal rift, which is partly because that's how organizations work, and partly because it makes for good interactive storytelling. Wait, what? Hold on. Okay. Over the course of these games, you usually have to wind up siding with one side or another in any given conflict, so the elves, the dwarves, the mages, the organized religions, all of those things have at least one major rift running through them. That means, for each thing we cover, I'm probably going to have to explain both sides of its internal conflict. Okay, where's a good place to begin? Let's start with the mages. They're pretty important, after all. Okay, so, they're mages, they use magic, carry staves, that sort of thing, right? Yeah, though it's a little more complicated than that. In the Das, mages are super powerful, but they can't always control their own power. They're actually sort of like mutants in X-Men in that they're born with a gift of magic, and it's identified early on. But, because people are terrified of mages, they're kept under lock and key and are never truly free for their entire lives. Oh, that's sad. Why are people so afraid of mages? They're extremely powerful and can lose control of their power and... Wait, they're extremely powerful and can lose control of their power and become very dangerous. It all ties back to the connection mages have with the Fade. Okay, the Fade, what's that? The Fade is a parallel dimension where magical spirits and demons live. It's a little understood metaphysical realm where people go when they dream. And is super MDK Marshall with that 15-month resub. MDK Marshall, thank you so much for your continued support of the channel. Super appreciate it. Mages have more direct access to the Fade than normal people, which also means that spirits and demons within the Fade have access to mages. If a mage isn't careful, a demon can use them as a vessel to come out of the Fade, possessing the mage and turning them into what's called an abomination, a super powerful, deadly monster. Everyone's terrified of that happening because if it does, your helpful friend the mage can suddenly and irrevocably become a monster that you have to destroy, which is where the Templars come in. Okay, the Templars. Right, remember how I said there were two sides of everything in the Das? Well, one of the most common conflicts in every Dragon Age story involves mages and Templars. The mages in Ferelden and Orle are all identified at a young age, documented and sent to live in one of the few circles of Magi, which are like a combination between a training academy and a prison. Once in a circle, mages are watched over by Templars, knights who have injected themselves with magic to become able to counteract the mages' powers should they need to. Wait, so you can just become magical by injecting themselves with magic? That's kind of cool. Ooh, quick lore video. That's cool. So you can just be like, I'm gonna be a magic person now. That's kind of neat. Alright. Circle mages live sheltered, largely peaceful lives, but they're always under the watchful eye of the Templars. If a mage steps out of line, or is discovered to have been visiting the Fade to talk to demons, he or she is usually killed. Other times, the Templars perform a ritual on a mage that makes them tranquil, which is like giving them a magical lobotomy. It serves as the mage's connection, or it severs the mage's connection with the Fade, removes their magical ability, and erases their personality and emotions. Ugh. Some mages reject the circle, however, and go live in the woods. I mean, secret. They're known as apostates. Apostates? Yeah. Templars then have their own mage hunters who go into the world, track down apostates, and kill them. Wow. So let's not be a mage? Sounds like it sucks to be a mage. Sounds like Templars are kind of jerks. Alright, well, that's not really fair. There's certainly an argument that if left unsupervised, enough mages would fall victim to demons in the Fade that the world would be overrun by abominations and all mankind would be exterminated. Also, power-hungry mages sometimes begin to practice blood magic, a terrifying form of magic that's expressly outlawed across the realm. Even a mage-friendly Teventer, blood magic uses the blood inside of us to fuel powerful spells and generally winds up involving mass human sacrifice, demonic summoning, and other messed up stuff. Alright. Yikes! Right, so, Templars aren't just jerks who keep nice mages in line, they're the first and last line of defense between mages who could very easily, even accidentally, become demonically possessed super monsters, blood magic using maniacs, or some combination of the two. The Templars don't always love their job, and some of them are pretty cool people. Just like a lot of mages are cool people, Templars view their responsibility as crucial to the maintained safety of humanity. It's a holy calling, actually. Yeah, alright. We are preparing to play Dragon Age Inquisition. Yep. Holy! Actually, you'd mentioned religion before. How does that fit in? Religion is actually a pretty big deal in Dragon Age games. Templars are actually a division of the Chantry, which is the dominant religion in the DAS. I like the... Okay. The DAS is real. That religion follows the teachings of the prophet... Andrest? I'm gonna go with Andrest. A long dead woman who is basically their Jesus Christ. And its followers are called Andrestians. Andrestians? Alright. As a term, the Chantry is used like how we say the Catholic Church. The actual thing that people follow is called the Chant of the Chant of Andrest. Andestay? Oh, wait. Really? Andrastean. Alright. Now I think you're all just trolling. Thedas? Yeah, I know it's Thedas, but it's called the Das. Alright. Okay, so who is the Andestre? Andestre was a slave who lived a super long time ago, back when Teventar Imperium ruled almost all of the Das. Think of it like this. Teventar was a Roman Empire, and Andestre was JC. At the time, most humans worshipped the seven old gods, a multitude of pagan beings who were believed to resemble a massive dragon. The old gods had names like Dumat, the Dragon of Silence, and Toth, the Dragon of Fire. Oh crap. Hold on. Alright. Andestre escaped her enslavement and claimed that she was visited in dreams by a supreme creator called the Maker, who told her that he had abandoned his creations because mankind had turned away from him and begun worshipping the old gods. She and her husband, who happened to be a warlord, eventually led a massive and largely successful uprising against the Imperium, all in the name of their new god. At the height of her influence, Andestre was betrayed by her own people and publicly burned at the stake by the Imperium. Thanks to at least thanks at least to partly to her, or wait, thanks at least partly to her martyrdom, her rebellion, and the religion she started stuck around. In fact, the Imperium Archon, who ordered her execution, was eventually overcome by remorse and became the first person to convert to, oh wait, the first person to convert to follow the chant. So is the Maker real? Did he actually visit Andestray? It's never clear, and that's the point. The chant is a religion, and so it requires faith. Some characters in the Dragon Age games believe in Andestray, others don't. Some aren't sure. Scholars across the DAS endlessly argue about what really happened, which parts of Andestray's story are fact and which parts are myth. You get to define your own character, so you can be a devout follower, an atheist, or a doubter. Just like with any religion, your faith is up to you. Alright, got it. What's the Chantry like all these years later? The modern-day Chantry is a massive organization with its own internal rifts and political strife. Generally speaking, they function a bit like the Catholic Church does in the real world. The Andestrian Chantry is led by a woman known as the Divine, who is a lot like the Pope. Every so often, a new Divine is elected and rules over the faithful across the whole of the DAS. At the start of Inquisition, the Divine is a woman named Justinia I, simply known, or known simply as Divine Justinia. I think that all makes sense. Sure. To summarize, the divine ruler of the Chantry controls the Templars, and the Templars guard the Circle of the Magi, which is where the mages live. The mages aren't actually part of the Chantry, but just submit to the Chantry's rule. Unless they're apostates, then they live freely, but are always at risk of demonic possession and on the run from Templar mage hunters. Holy crap. Okay. Cool. So, you're really just talking about human stuff here, right? Yeah. Those are mostly just things that humans concern themselves with, or at least the stuff with mages, Templars, and the Chantry are all generally organized and driven by humans. Really, humans drive a lot of what happens in the DAS, for better or often for worse. Okay, so what about the other races? The elves, the dwarves, and so on. What's this for? What's this straw poll for? Oh, what race? Yeah, you guys can go ahead and vote on that one. I don't know what that is, but I'm voting for it. So, what about the other races? Okay, let's get to those. There are a few different races we should address. Elves, who have pointy ears, live in the woods, and have lost touch with their cultural roots. Dwarves, who are short, like beards, live in kingdoms underground, and craft all manner of amazing shit out of stone. And the Narnia, a race of towering horned men and women who strictly adhere to their own fundamentalist religion, and the Darkspawn, a race of twisted beasts that rise up from beneath the earth and constantly threaten to overrun it. Neat. Kunari? That's what I assumed. Kunari is actually kind of a cool name. I like Kunari. The Narnia. It's official. Some of those sound weird. Let's start with the elves. I like elves. What? How do some of those sound weird? The only one that sounds weird is, like, the Kunari and the Darkspawn, and that's just because we don't... Okay, whatever. James Gnostic. Alright. Some of those sound weird. Let's start with the elves. I like elves! Alright, cool. In the DAS, elves look more or less like the elves you become familiar with in other fantasy stories. They're small, thin, have big eyes and pointy ears. They can use magic, and are often good with bows and arrows. So, they're like Legolas. Not really. I mean, a little. No, they're not really like Legolas. I like Legolas. Yeah, I mean, I like Legolas too. The part where he shield surfs down the stairs, you know? Yeah, that was pretty cool. Okay, so what makes Dragon Age elves different? Mostly, it's the way they're treated by the rest of the world. Elves have been grossly oppressed over the centuries, subjugated by just about every ruling human power. In cities, elves live in ghettos called exiles, where they're denied access to the rest of the cities and frequently live in filth and disease. They're not kept as slaves anymore outside of Teventar, but they're often mistreated or fall into indentured servitude. The thing is, elves actually have a rich history, and ancient elves were extremely powerful beings who harnessed the secrets of the universe in ways that even modern mages can't match. Unfortunately, ancient elven history has all been but erased. ghettos are now exiles, yeah. Unfortunately, ancient elven history has been all but erased, and the elves themselves have lost track of a lot of their own cultural identity. While ancient elven artifacts remain scattered about the world, most modern elves in the Das are a thin at best connection with their ancestry. However, some elves reject this reject human society and choose to live in the wilds, attempting to preserve their so they're like Fuji. He lives in the woods, right? Attempting to preserve their culture and revive old tradition. They're known as the Dalish, and they live in forests, ornate themselves with elaborate facial tattoos, and greatly distrust outsiders. They keep to their own traditions, move their encampments from place to place, and consider themselves outside the law of the nations of the Das. They also look down upon any elves who choose to go live in cities, join the mage's circle, follow the chant, or attempt to blend in with human-dominated society. So people are pretty mean to the elves, huh? Yeah, elves are treated awfully a lot of the time, and casual racism towards them is even more pervasive than actual elf hatred. People call elves slurs like knife ear, that sort of thing. It's a bummer, and you'll see it quite a bit if you choose to play as an elf character. Oh, that's sad. Okay, now dwarves. Let's do dwarves. You got it. Dwarves in Dragon Age are a lot like dwarves in Tolkien. There's no big unique twist or anything. They're short and sturdily built, they're master craftsmen, and they build vast underground cities out of stone. However, they do not all talk with Scottish accents, which is nice. Such a random trope, right? Don't even get me started. So, dwarves live in underground kingdoms housed in cities known as thegs, and organize their society according to a strict caste system. They have a governing assembly and are overseen by a king. They also occasionally elevate a dwarf to title of paragon, usually for some extraordinary deed. A paragon becomes the leader of a new noble house. Dwarven society is pretty rigorously structured, and the caste system can be brutally enforced. Dwarven politics played a pretty large role in Dragon Age Origins, and one of the game's many playable origin stories, The Dwarf Noble, allowed for a really fun navigation of the political underbelly of the Dwarven Kingdom, Orgrimmar. Come on, that one was just sitting right there. They sound like basic fantasy dwarves. What makes them special? Dragon Age dwarves are most notable for a few things. For starters, they are unable to enter the Fade, and thus entirely unable to use magic. They also don't dream. Aww. Their disconnection from the Fade makes them immune to the effects of blue lyrium, the raw magical material that both mages and templars use to channel magic energy and create magic items. As a result, dwarves are able to mine lyrium and make a ton of money selling it to circle mages and templars on the surface. How far is the download? 52%. We're getting there. Secondly, dwarves all live underground and are super hardcore about any of their number who go out and live on the surface. That's at least partly because for a variety of reasons, dwarves' numbers have been dwindling over the years, and they're concerned about ensuring the future of their race. All dwarves have been... All dwarves have preternatural connection with the earth, which they call cat or stone sense. If a dwarf lives on the surface for too long, he or she loses a resistance to lyrium. Lyrium? Is it lyrium? I assume it's lyrium. Yeah, the internet here at the moon base is pretty good. As well as the ability to sense the stone around them, once a dwarf has left to live on the surface, he or she is not really welcome back underground. The last thing probably transitions us to our next topic. Dwarves are largely defined by their centuries-long conflict with the Darkspawn. Lyrium? Alright. What the fuck? That guy doesn't look cool. Okay, Darkspawn, let's do it. Alright, they're monsters, they kind of look like orcs from Lord of the Rings, and they're called Darkspawn. That's a pretty silly name. Yeah, I know. Everyone agrees it's a dumb name. What? I don't think it's a dumb name. I just kind of think it's a lazy name. It's like, Darkspawn. Okay. Why not call them... Shamu. We'll call them Shamu. We're not gonna call them Shamu. Alright. There's kind of nothing for it at this point, but they're a pretty big deal, so we should talk about them. Alright, what are the Darkspawn? The Darkspawn used to be humans, or dwarves, or elves, but they've been hopelessly corrupted. As legend goes, back before Andrastate's time, the Teventar Magisters grew so powerful and reckless that using a ritual that involved an ungodly amount of lyrium, blood magic, and a bunch of human sacrifices, they managed to open a door to the Fade and physically enter it. That's a big deal, since usually the only way into the Fade is while dreaming, with a mental projection of yourself. You said it, it's canon. X-Files and Shamu! So the Teventar Mages opened a rift and made their way into the Golden City, a mysterious place at the heart of the Fade, thought to be the center of all creation. Their greed and pride corrupted the city, and it transformed into the Black City, which is what exists in the Fade today. The Magisters who stepped into the Golden City were blighted and became twisted beasts who immediately began to destroy everything in their path. Those Magisters were the very first Darkspawn. Yeesh. This sounds like kind of an original sin, yeah? Yeah, kind of like that. So hold up. This sounds like religion stuff again. Did these things actually happen, or are they just myths that people in the Das tell one another? It's difficult to say for sure. In one of the Dragon Age 2 DLC packs, the hero Hawk runs into and eventually destroys a super powerful Darkspawn named Corey Feldman, who claims he's one of the original Magisters who entered the Golden City way back in the day. It's left unclear whether his claim is true or not, but it certainly seems possible. So while a lot of this stuff is kept deliberately unclear and open to interpretation, those events lend credence to the idea that at least some of these things really did happen at some point. What? Do 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 do. All right. Okay, so what happened after the Magisters despoiled the Golden City? The Magisters, now Darkspawn, came back through the Fade and attacked the world. If people were wounded by Darkspawn in battle or became infected by Darkspawn blood, they would succumb to the taint. The taint. P.S. No one types with zeros anymore. Jesus Christ. Hey, leave me alone. I'll type out noob however I want. Lots of people still type with zero. Alright, the taint. Seriously, the taint. And becomes ghouls who serve the Darkspawn, so it was a bit of a zombie apocalypse. Everyone called the Darkspawn invasion the Blight, and it lasted 200 years. Eh, that's not that bad. 200 years, whatever. Sounds shitty. It was! Everyone pretty much figured it was the end of the world. Good lord, so many emails. The Darkspawn swept across the planet's surface while digging into the depths below, making their way around via a vast network of dwarf-built underground highways known as the Deep Roads. They uncovered a buried Elder God Dragon, in this case, Dumat, the God of Silence, and reanimated it. Dumat returned to the world as an unstoppable undead dragon known as the Archdemon. Nah, he doesn't look that bad. The Deep Roads. Let's slow down. This is a lot to digest. So there's a Blight, there are Darkspawn, and then there's an Archdemon? Right. Those three things all sort of go hand in hand. Eventually the Darkspawn were defeated, the Archdemon was killed, and the Blight ended, but they never really went away. The Darkspawn linger down in the deep rocks, and they're always digging, looking for new Elder Gods to uncover and bring back. Each time they dig up a new Archdemon, it unites them and they invade the surface, kicking off another Blight. I like how you can just dig around for enough time. Dumat the Nummy. Yeah, exactly. Okay, I think I get it. How did everyone stop the first Blight? With the help of an order of warriors called the Grey Wardens. Grey Wardens. Okay, lots of different factions in this game, eh? Yeah, but this one is, this is one of the last ones you'll have to keep straight. The Grey Wardens are a pretty big deal in Dragon Age. They were founded way back during the first Blight when a group of elite warriors, desperate for a way to fight the Darkspawn, tried ingesting Darkspawn blood to see if it would give them special power. The blood killed most people who took it, but a few survived. Those few found themselves linked to the Darkspawn, able to sense their presence and to see into the mind of the Archdemon. Eventually, enough warriors survived the initiation to form an order called the Grey Wardens, who turned the tide of blight and eventually killed the Archdemon. As it turns out, Archdemons are nigh unkillable, except by a Grey Warden. Who can... Wait, so they are unkillable except by something that didn't exist until it existed? Okay, whatever. Except for by a Grey Warden who can kill the demon by sacrificing his or her own life, so ended the first Blight. The intro cinematic to Dragon Age Origins actually summed up the whole thing pretty well. You can watch that here. Nah, that's too much work. How many Blights have there been in total? 5. Good God. I would move away from this place. The first game in the series, Dragon Age Origins, told the story of the 5th Blight. Players controlled a guy or lady who was conscripted into the Grey Wardens early on and eventually brought down an Archdemon. This time, Urethra? Let's go with Urethra. The God Dragon of Beauty. Oh, that's mean. Urthemiel. Urthemiel. Let's go with Urthemiel. The God Dragon of Beauty. Thus ending the Blight and saving the world. But even when there isn't a Blight, the Grey Wardens hang around? Yeah, because there's always the chance that Darkspawn will find another Archdemon, and the Wardens will be needed again. Urethra. They're all a little bit crazy since they live out on the fringes and are ready to sacrifice their lives should the need arise. They're actually a lot like the Night's Watch in Game of Thrones. They'll accept anyone of any class, background, or race. They don't care if you're a criminal or a nobleman, and once you join, there's no unjoining. They're all just kind of dour and carry the weight of the world on their shoulders. But because the Blight isn't always in effect, people sometimes stop listening to them or taking them seriously. Alright. Got it. So, Grey Wardens are basically the Night's Watch. They're the Darkspawn busters of the Das. You mentioned the Darkspawn have a special relationship with the Dwarves? Yeah, because the Darkspawn live underground and travel via the Deep Roads, the Dwarves have had to deal with them up close ever since the first Blight. People who live on the surface rarely see Darkspawn unless there's a Blight going on, but they're a constant menace for Dwarves who live underground. The Darkspawn have greatly thinned the Dwarven ranks over the years, and the Darkspawn taint is widely thought to cause sterility among Dwarven adults. As a result, Dwarves can get kind of testy with surface dwellers about the Darkspawn. It's kind of always Blight time for the Dwarves. Oh, that sucks. Sucks to be Dwarves. Makes sense. Alright, let's move on to the Qunari. Those don't really sound like any fantasy race I'm familiar with. What's their story? The Qunari are pretty cool. They are commonly understood to be a race of huge horned people who live according to the strict religion they call the Qun. That said, anyone of the race who follows the Qun can be considered a Qunari, and if a member of the Qunari race abandons the Qun, they are exiled and become known as Tal Vashoth. Let's go with Vashoth. Inquisition actually gives you the option of playing as a Tal Vashoth Qunari, which is a first for the series. James is brushing up on his Dragon Age lore so that he can play Dragon Age Inquisition in 44%. Alright, the Qunari are fearsome warriors, kind of like the Vikings of the Das. They do a lot of conquering. They arrived in the Das a long time ago. As invaders and nearly took over the entire place before losing a lot of their land in various wars. They currently occupy a region to the far northeast called Parvolan and are involved in a lengthy war with the Teventar Imperium. That war is actually one of the main reasons the Imperium has lost much of its power elsewhere. Last time I checked was 50-some-odd%. It should be done in like 15 minutes or so. It doesn't give me any sort of time. It's already at 66. We're fine. The Qunari are fearsome warriors. Oh, wait, we already read that. Alright. Okay, got it. I think that's all the races, right? Yeah, that about does it. Okay, you've alluded to the stories of the first two games. Where do things stand at the start of Inquisition? There's too much to summarize here, since each of the first two games was incredibly long, featured a shitload of different characters, and took dozens of hours to complete. The thing you should really do once you finish reading this is go ahead and do the Dragon Age Keep. Oh yeah, you mentioned that earlier. So the Keep is a web app that let me go through the stories of the first two games. Yeah, it's slick, but it's pretty confusing if you don't understand all the basics I just laid out here. Once you know how the Blight works and what a Grey Warden is, and the difference between a Dalish elf and a City elf, it gets a lot easier to follow. Then you can decide what happens in the first two games, which will change some stuff, like who is the current ruler of Ferelden, and what became of the mages in Kirkwall, that sort of thing. Then you can import your custom world state into your Inquisition game, no matter what platform you're on. Okay, I'll do that. Well, or maybe not. For now, can you just kind of summarize? Sure. Let's start with the origins. Origins took place in Felderon. Felderon? That's not even... Origins took place in Alderaan and told the story of the Fifth Blight, like I said. The player is some random jerk, maybe a city elf, maybe a dwarven noble, maybe a circle mage, who gets conscripted by the Grey Wardens and winds up at a battle where King Kaelin and Ferelden's top commander, a guy named Loghane, betrays the king and lets him die, throwing the whole nation into turmoil, just as the Blight threatens to swallow everything. Excuse me. Link to this article. Crap. No. It's on Kotaku. I can't copy-paste. I'll get it to you in a minute. That sounds like a pretty punk move. Loghane has his reasons. The king was sort of a dope. That battle leaves the main character as one of the last of the Grey Wardens, and he or she has to form a coalition, enact a bunch of old treaties to help to get help from various nobles, mages, and others around Ferelden. Unite the kingdom and mount a last-ditch attack on the Archdemon. Sounds exciting! It was! Origins was a really good game. Things could go a whole bunch of different ways, but in the end, the hero faced off against the Archdemon and killed it, ending the Blight and saving the world. Depending on the choices you made, the ending could mean your hero sacrificed him or herself to kill the Archdemon, or let a friend do it, or let an apostate mage named Morgan become pregnant with a demon baby that stops the Archdemon or something. Wait, what? Yeah, that's definitely the weird option for the ending. We'll get to Morgan in a second. Okay. So anyway, Dragon Age 2 is pretty much totally unrelated story that picks up during the same time period of Origins, during the Fifth Blight. While the Grey Warden from the first game was off fighting the Darkspawn, the hero of the sequel, a man or woman named Hawk, led his or her family from Felderon to the city of Kirkwall. Kirkwall is located in the Free Marches, which, if you remember from before, is a ruler's region located north of Ferelden across the Walking Sea. I don't remember them saying that it was across the sea, but whatever. Sounds good. What is Kirkwall like? It's kind of a shit show, really. Upon Hawk's arrival, the city is overrun with refugees from Ferelden, who are trying to flee the Blight. There's a huge gap between the wealthy nobles and the poor folk in the streets, and the whole place is teetering on the brink of falling apart. Meanwhile, the conflict between the city's mages and Templars has gotten extremely tense, and Templars are right off the verge of killing all the mages in the city once and for all. So what happens in the game? The story was more of a mess than the first game, and didn't have nearly as clear of a narrative thrust. It takes place over a decade? Holy crap. A few key things happened in that time. Discovery of Red Lyrium, and the start of the Mage's Rebellion. Okay, let's start with the Red Lyrium. You mentioned Lyrium before. That's basically a mage-infused material, right? Yeah, it's sort of like... It's this sort of blue glowing ore that mages use to craft magical items and Templars ingest to make themselves resistant to magic. Think of it as mana for other fantasy RPGs made into sort of a mineral. Got it. Red Lyrium is apparent from a Lyrium that no one had really seen before the events of Dragon Age 2. Hawk went on an expedition into the Deep Roads led by a couple of dwarven brothers named Varric and Bertrand Thetras. Thetras. Varric is actually the narrator of Dragon Age 2, as well as a party member, and he returns as a major character and party member in Inquisition. Oh, okay. I think I remember seeing videos of him where Dragon Age 2 was out. He's a cool dude. Definitely one of the best characters in the game. So this expedition uncovers some red lyrium and an artifact made of stuff that makes its way back to Kirkwall. Bertrand? Oh yeah, I guess it is just Bertrand. Anyways, it'll be much easier when I start hearing these names actually spoken out loud. It falls into the hands of the leader of Kirkwall Templars, a woman named Meredith, and turns out it's pretty much pure evil. It corrupts Meredith, and she orders the murder of every mage in Kirkwall. Oh, that sucks. Yikes, can she do that? Technically, yeah, but really everything in Kirkwall just kind of falls apart at that point. Hawk can choose to side with Meredith or with the mages, but it's the beginning of the end either way. When I played, I sided with the mages and eventually killed Meredith. She was kind of an asshole even before she became corrupted by the Red Lyrium, so I didn't feel too bad about it. Actually, come to think of it, I had to kill the mage's leader as well, because it turned out he was practicing blood magic, so he became an abomination. It was all pretty dumb, really. What about the other thing? The Mage Rebellion. That's more complicated. One of the main companion characters in Dragon Age 2 is a mage named Anders, who is also a Grey Warden. Hawk meets Anders in Kirkwall and fights alongside him throughout the story. Anders is opposed to the entire notion of the Circle of Mages, the Templars, the Chantry. He thinks all mages should be free. He grows more and more radical over the course of the story and finally takes extreme action by setting off a massive blast of magical energy and destroying the Kirkwall Chantry, killing everyone inside. That incident is a flashpoint for the mage uprising that stretches far beyond Kirkwall. Regardless of what players choose to do with Andres, at the end of DA2, you can kill him, stick with him, or set him free. The Mage Rebellion is underway. All around Orlis and Felrodon, Ferelden, the mage circles begin to dissolve. Mages openly defy the Chantry and begin to live as apostates, and everything gets pretty gnarly. Which, more or less, is where things pick up at the beginning of Dragon Age Inquisition. At the beginning of the new game, Divine Justinia has called a meeting with the leaders of the Templars and the mages in an attempt to broker peace. Okay, I get it. I'm gonna go do the Dragon Age Keep now, but are there any other characters I should know from the previous games? There are a few. Let's run them down. Cassandra Pentagast is a Chantry warrior detective known as Seeker of Truth. She was sent in to determine why the Kirkwall Chantry was destroyed and what had become of Hawk. Cassandra brings Varric the Dwarf in for questioning, and their back and forth frames the story of Dragon Age 2. Yeah, my tongue is like blah. Morgan is an apostate mage who was a major character in Origins. She is first found living in the woods with her mother, Flemeth, and learning all sorts of ancient mysterious magic. She wears a dress made out of leather belts and is a bit of a fan favorite. Flemeth is Morgan's mother. She initially introduced as the Witch of the Wilds, though at the end of Origins, it's revealed that she's more than just some mage. She has the ability to turn into a huge, extremely powerful dragon, among other things. She also turns up at the beginning of Dragon Age 2 to guide Hawk to Kirkwall, setting the events of that game in motion. Her true nature has always been a bit of a mystery, and is the truth of her relationship with her daughter. Varric is the dwarf who narrated Dragon Age 2. I already talked about him. He's a good bro. Sister Lalina is a lay sister of the Chantry. She's also a bard, an assassin, and a spy. She was a main companion character in Origins, a master archer who is super well connected and always knew what was happening around the world. She made only a brief appearance in DA2, but in Inquisition she returns to serve as the Inquisition's ruthless spy master. Alright, that's it. That's not all that many extra characters. Well, there were a lot more, but those are the only ones where reference to them might be confusing if you didn't know who they were before you started playing. Okay, I'm feeling pretty good about all this. Cool! And hey, don't be afraid to take time to read the in-game codex or to browse the excellent Dragon Age Wiki. That's where I dug up a lot of the finer details here and where I fact-checked the stuff I wasn't totally sure about. Thanks for all the information. My pleasure. We should grab a drink or get dinner sometime. I'd like that. Okay, we did it. We read it all. And we're at 83%. Holy crap, that was a long read. So, I will say that there's another article here, which is tips for playing Dragon Age Inquisition, which I guess we can quick... Well, this thing is just as insanely long. Let's just quickly scroll through this thing. Brush up on lore, we did that. Do the Dragon Age Keep, we didn't do that yet. Go with whichever race feels right. Consider playing a mage. Wait, what? Alright, take your time with character creator. It's okay to restart. Turn down lip shine. Ugh. Alright, we'll turn down lip shine. That's good to know. On PC, set meshes to high. Alright, fine, we'll do the stupid key. I don't actually know if we... hold on. Can I log in with my... Origin? Here we go. All right. Dragon Age people recognize your hero data, blah, 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 blah. All right. I'm confused. It's not going to find anything. Wait, what? So is this just for the sake of this? I do get to create a new character, right? Huh. Just go all random? How do I even do that? I don't know how, it doesn't give me a random option. But this is all backstory. All right, so this doesn't really matter. So can I just choose this hero? All right, screw this. All right, my Dragon Age 2. Sure. Huh. You get to choose all the decisions later. All right, well. Okay. I'm confused.
If you believe the stories, mankind's pride gave rise to the Darkspawn.
Wait, don't we already know all this?
In number and toxic to all life, Darkspawn search endlessly for an archdemon. When they find one, Darkspawn armies surge up from their corrupt barrows beneath the ground, and a blight begins. Grey Wardens are the only warriors capable of destroying an archdemon, and history always honors the one who sacrifices all to kill the beast. In the Fifth Blight, the Warden was the hero of Ferelden, a hunter from a clan of Dalish elves. The hero discovered a corrupted elven artifact and was tainted by the same foul magic that drives the Darkspawn. The only cure for the young elf was to join Duncan as the Grey Warden. The allied Ferelden and Grey Warden forces met in Ostagar, where King Kaelin's armies and a host of wardens gathered, ready to destroy the Darkspawn.
All right.
But Valor turned to despair as Loghain betrayed his king. Kaelin's forces were slaughtered, and the south was lost. The hero, now a full-fledged Grey Warden, survived with the aid of Flemeth, the mysterious Witch of the Wilds. Joined by Flemeth's daughter, Morrigan, and a Grey Warden named Alistair, the hero set out to build an army strong enough to abolish the Blight. With the traitorous Loghain now seated on Ferelden's throne, the Warden sought help from the influential Arl Eamon of Redcliffe. However, they arrived in Redcliffe to find the town under siege. As each night, undead rose in waves and assailed the battered village. With the hero's help, the people of Redcliffe stood fast against the undead horde. The wardens reached Arl Eamon's castle only to find the Arl lying at the edge of death and his court fallen into madness. To save his father's life.
Oh. Boom.
If Eamon's young son, Connor, had made a deal with a demon and quickly fallen victim to its possession. The hero intervened, freeing Connor from possession and breaking the demon's hold over Redcliff.
But this is kind of weird.
Demons are never straightforward. The demon agreed only to save Eamon's life, not restore him to health. Arl Eamon needed a miracle to recover. The hero located an urn containing the sacred ashes of Andraste, which were said to cure any ailment.
Okay.
The urn was protected by ancient traps, tests of will, and a dragon-worshipping cult that wanted to...
Did the warden poison the urn of sacred ashes? See, this is a little weird because... making these choices makes no sense. Like, this feels like it's designed for people who ran through these games but didn't have the save files. Not somebody who didn't. Because this makes no sense to me. Like, I don't know if the warden poisoned the urn of sacred ashes. That doesn't make any sense to me. So there's no context for any of this. So I feel like I should just not do this. Yeah, so... but then why does it... okay. I'm just not gonna do it, because... it seems weird. 97%! Let's just do this, guys. Yeah, we're not gonna do the keep. The keep is kind of weird. Alright. Let's read Trin's thing real quick. Somebody asks, I just got DA Inquisition on the PS4 sale. It will be my first Dragon Age game. What do I need to know? Oh my gosh, welcome to the party. Hello, okay, so here's my advice. Read both of the Dragon Age guides. So we read this one. We didn't read the second one, which is the tips for playing, but I might look at that later. Dragon Age is the most fantasy-esque RPG-esque of the fantasy RPGs. The characters are compelling, the universe is full of full and vibrant, and crazy shit happens like all of the time, so keep on your toes. Talk to every character you can and ask every possible question. The game is better when you know your party members, but also there are quests to be had when you go through conversations. Not just with your friends, but also with random-ass NPCs. Check in with it often. And then there's some crossed-out shit, so we won't worry about that. Leave the fucking Hinterlands. The Hinterlands is basically the starting zone. Do not try to clear the Hinterlands. It's not meant to be cleared. At least not in the beginning of the game. Move on over to other zones. Do other things. Pick up your party members. As you probably are aware, since you are on Tumblr right now, you can smooch people in this game. It's great. Some people like dudes, some people like ladies, some people like both. Some people are racist and won't date you if you're a dwarf or whatever, which I think is kind of nonsense, but okay. Smooch whomever you want. Don't worry about what the fandom thinks. Alright. It is okay to care more about the plot than smooching. It is okay to care more about smooching than killing dragons. It is okay to hate Dragon Age in its entirety and throw it into garbage and never think about it again. It's a video game. Everyone will still love you. Let me know who you smooch. Okay, thanks, bye. Alright. I think we're good. Installing. Oh, goddammit. Hey, Dragon Age, ready to play! Syncing cloud data. excuse me. Holy crap, sorry guys. Ugh. Alright. Probably gonna make myself disappear. Alright, let's change this again. Hanging out with dragons. Hanging out with dragons. Alright. Meltalar with that 8-month resub. Meltalar, thank you so much for your continued support of the channel. I super appreciate it. Thank you. Thumbs up. All right. Are you ready? I'm ready. Let's kill this. Or kill my player cam here. Boop. We're gonna kill my mic. Actually, we're not gonna do that quite yet because I don't know if it's gonna go into... Alright. The music is kind of legit. Let's quickly look at the options. Gameplay. Ooh, enable persistent gore. Seems decent. Okay. Controls. Do I want to use a gamepad or mouse or keyboard? I have both. Key bindings, audio, dialogue. Enable subtitles on. I'm just gonna go with conversations. Yeah, I would think we'd be with a gamepad. Yes, confirm changes. What? It's plugged in. Hold on. I can bring back the webcam for now. I killed it just because I assumed there was going to be an intro pretty quick there. There we go. Alright. Graphics. Sure. Mesh quality. Ultra. I assume the lip shine is in the character creation. Alright. New game. Yeah, this is what I thought. Oh, god damn it. Alright. What was the vote at? Yeah, that's what I was gonna play anyways. Alright. Wait. Play female, elf. Probably just going to be an archer, because that's kind of my go-to thing. So, I mean, I guess we could do... Should I do mage? You guys are all saying elf mage. If it was up to me, I'd probably play a rogue, like a rogue archer. We voted mage. I don't care what you voted. Archer is bomb. Yeah. Eh, I'm gonna go with the archer for now. We're gonna go on normal. Alright. Enslaved long ago by humans, most elves still live in a second-class citizens. Within human cities, elves who reject this life are known as the Dalish, nomadic wanderers who strive to keep the ancient elven religion and traditions alive. You were raised in the wilderness to be a hunter, relied upon by the Lavalin clan for food and protection. The clan wandered the northern free marches and had little need to interact with humans, until the clan's keeper sent you to the Chantry's conclave as a spy. What happened there, she said, would impact not only the Dalish, but indeed all elves. She could not have known how right she was. But this is a democracy! Wait, what? This is a democracy? I don't think it is. I'm pretty sure you're wrong. Alright. We're gonna hit OK. No, let's not do that, because I don't think that's actually gonna do anything. Alright. I assume I'm gonna have to go away here. Or not. Let's get rid of this. The color of a creature's rank. Wait, I didn't even... Okay. Mounts are the fastest way to travel across the land. Character creation or cutscene? Damn it, that's not a cutscene. The game tricked me. It's either one. Or three. Ooh. Maybe five. No, let's go three. No. Or if you're gonna go five. Ooh! Name your character. Well, that's easy. Hope you appreciate it, Trin. You're the reason why I'm playing this game. I just realized that that didn't do anything. No! Can I go back? Or do I have to start again? Yeah, no. Crap. No! Wait. Start again. No! Crap. All right. Here's what we're gonna do, guys. We're gonna go to a quick commercial break. We're gonna booth here for a second. Quick commercial break. I'm gonna really quickly restart because that was stupid. Because I do want to customize, obviously. And I'll be back in just a couple minutes, and I'll get us right back to the custom creation for our character. So, 3 minutes, guys, and we'll be back. We need to take a break anyway, so that's fine. Be right back. As promised, back at the character creation. All right, here we go. General. Oh, crap. Why is this not working? Does my mouse and keyboard work? Yeah. Wait, no. Hold on. Something wrong with our controller, I think. Come on, work. Seriously? Why is this not working? Boo! What up, moose-filled cat? There we go. Hey, there we go. Alright. Alright. Long face. We're gonna go with that one. That's This game looks gorgeous, by the way. Seriously, controller, what is wrong with you? Ah! No! This is not good. I don't know if we have another controller that I can use. Yeah, I'm aware of the lip shine. Not gonna be able to do much if this damn controller is not working though. No, it's not. It's the controller. It's not the USB port, I don't think. Anyways. Boom. Hair. Hair has got to be like the one thing in these games that still just kind of looks silly. Which is why I almost like that look. Yeah, there's no mohawk, which is a little sad. Ooh, that's sweet. Bald. Which one did I like there? I actually kind of like the one in the bun. Just the bun. It seems like that would be good hair for a adventuring elf lady to have. You know, doesn't get in her eyes or face, you know. It makes sense. Like, this hair just seems silly. Like, that's just gonna get in your face. And you're trying to, like, shoot people with your bow and arrow and be kick-ass badass. Alright. We're gonna stick with the bun. The Janeway? Yeah. The Janeway is real. Alright, hair color. Nope. Probably just gonna stick with the brown. Yeah, that's not bad. Kinda like that. Yeah, there's no bright pink hair. Or highlights or anything like that. Ooh, actually. Yes, there we go.
You leave me no choice. Everything you've heard? Completely true.
I just hope I can help.
Wait, really? There's only two?
You leave me no choice. Everything you've heard? Completely true.
Alright, well. Head and ears. Ear size. Whoa, this is cool. I like big ears, but that aren't that pointy. Let's go smaller. Let's go right there. Let's go kind of high on the ears. Keep them in. Earlobe size. Damn earlobes. Cheekbones. Wow, this game is redonk. cheek shape. Ooh, brow size. Holy crap, this game. You have big eyes. Eye position. No, I don't like that. Eye rotation. Okay. Eyebrow style. Why would we want to make her look as silly as we can? That's, no, I don't want her to be silly as possible. Let's go with the higher eyebrows. Ooh, eyelash style. Cool. Outer eye. Jesus. Nose. Jesus. I kind of like the nose, actually. Ooh, broken nose. Cool. Yeah, let's give her a broken nose. Nose tip position. Pointy little nose. Alright, that's fine. Mouth and jaw. There we go. Where is it? Adam's apple. Weird. All right. Double chin, chin shape, jaw, lip. The hell? Scars. Scars are sweet. Ooh, no. Jesus. No, let's go. I want just, yeah, that's sweet. Scar intensity. There we go. Tattoo. Oh, right. Okay. No. Yeah, I think I like that eye one. Tattoo color. Give me that purple. Excellent. Okay. Makeup. Ah, there's lip shine. He said turn it way up, right? Turn it down. Lip liner? Are you kidding me? Alright. Eyeshadow. More purple. What up, the Nage face? Sick name. Under eye color. Alright. I'm feeling pretty good about this character so far. I think she looks kind of badass. Yeah, purple's my favorite color. Ugh. Elf Simulator 2015 off to a flying start. You know it. Alright. Except. Same as before. Oh. All right. Oops.
Tell me why we shouldn't kill you now. The Conclave is destroyed. Everyone who attended is dead, except for you.
Well then, I guess I'm making choices.
Explain this.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I don't know what that is, or how it got there.
You're lying!
We need her, Cassandra.
I don't understand.
Do you remember what happened? How this began?
I remember running. Things were chasing me, and then a woman?
A woman?
She reached out to me, but then...
Go to the forward camp, Liliana. I will take her to the rift.
Is the volume good?
What did happen?
It will be easier to show you.
Cool. Dear God. I did not do that.
It's a massive rift into the world of demons that grows larger with each passing hour. It's not the only such rift, just the largest. All were caused by the explosion at the Conclave.
An explosion can do that?
This one did. Unless we act, the breach may grow until it swallows the world. Each time the breach expands, your mark spreads, and it is killing you. It may be the key to stopping this, but there isn't much time.
Trying to decide what kind of person I want to be in this game. Kind of feel like being a little bit of a dick, but... what do you guys think? Should I play this straight, like, be like, if I can help, I'll do it, or be kind of like a, meh, be a little bit of a douche tool? Let's investigate, yeah.
You say it may be the key. To doing what?
Closing the breach. Whether that's possible is something we shall discover shortly. It is our only chance, however. And yours.
You still think I did this? To myself?
Not intentionally. Something clearly went wrong.
And if I'm not responsible?
Someone is. And you are our only suspect. You wish to prove your innocence? This is the only way.
So if I do what you want, will I live through it?
We have no way of knowing.
Let's find out. I'd like to play it as a little bit of a dick, but not like a massive
cock. They have decided
your
guilt. They need it. The people of Haven mourn our most holy, divine Justinia, head of the Chantry. The Conclave was hers. It was a chance for peace between mages and Templars. She brought their leaders together. Now they are dead. We lash out like the sky, but we must think beyond ourselves, as she did. Until the breach is sealed.
Now what are you doing?
There will be a trial. I can promise no more. Come. It is not far.
Where are you taking me?
Your mark must be tested on something smaller than the breach.
Damn. This game is pretty shit. I'm gonna jump on your head. I'm on your boxes. Whee! Alright.
Open the gate. We are heading into the valley.
Holy crap, you can jump? What? Yeah? Secrets? 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 Playing on the PC. Ooh. Whoa, what's that? Disengage. Alright. Pretty as shit. Is that a compliment? That jump animation, though. Alright, enough of that. Wait, can I go here? Ooh, I can. Ooh, secrets? Secrets? Alright. Ow! What the fuck?
The pulses are coming faster now.
The
larger the breach grows, the more rifts appear, the more demons we face.
How did I survive the blast?
They said you.
Control seems a little. Well, I guess that's not bad.
Unconscious.
Can you, like, zoom out at all?
Was in the rift behind you. No one knows who she was. Everything farther in the valley was laid waste, including the Temple of Sacred Ashes. I suppose you'll see.
Dear God. Will James take on Bloodborne this summer? No. I'm pretty sure this is the game I'll be playing for the rest of the summer.
Stay
behind me.
Oh, that's convenient. Ow. Just the summer.
Drop your weapon now.
Oh, shut up. You need to trust me, bitch.
If you're going to lead me through a demon-infested valley, you'll have to trust me.
Give me one reason to trust you.
Because my life is on the line.
You're right. I cannot protect you. And I cannot expect you to be defenseless.
Laser beaks, that's hilarious.
Your life is threatened enough as it is. Take your potions.
Wait, did I actually
know what we will face?
There we go. Oh.
Where are all your soldiers?
So
at
wait.
The forward camp. You're fighting.
Oops.
We are on our own for now.
Okay. So what's X do? Ooh. What? I can disappear in a cloud of goddamn smoke? Why didn't somebody tell me this much, much earlier in my life? I will take all. Cool. Abilities consume mana and stamina for powerful combat effects. Most abilities require time to pass me. Yeah, sure, that's fine.
There! Watch out!
Where?
If we flank them, we may gain the advantage.
Who wants to flank them when I can just do this? Oh god. Ow. I regret everything. Woohoo! I win. Seriously, you didn't kill that guy yet? You suck. Like I'm supposed to go this way. Stealth is much more important when you're using a dual-wielding rogue. Yeah. I'm just a shoot with a bow kind of girl. I want to loot your bodies. Or not, apparently. Alright. Okay. Anyways. Whoops. Damn it. I didn't mean to do that.
Up on the hill. It attacks from a distance.
Nope. Can't target it from there, apparently. Dominated! Let's keep going. Doop 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 doop.
Ah! They're falling from the breach.
I'm so good at this game. Who needs stealth when you can shoot them with a bow? Uh-oh. Wow. That attack just completely hoses those green dudes. Also, I feel like I need, like, a close combat weapon here.
We're getting close to the rift. You can hear the fighting.
Who's fighting?
You'll see soon. We must help them.
Why don't you just tell me who's fighting? What's this way? Secrets? Secrets? No secrets. What do you need? Game override? Oh, that was weird. Hey, is it that dude? What? Thanks for asking.
What did you do?
I did nothing. The credit is yours.
I closed that thing. How?
Whatever magic opened the breach in the sky also placed that mark upon your hand. I theorized the mark might be able to close the rifts that have opened in the breach's wake. And it seems I was correct.
Meaning it could also close the breach itself.
Possibly. It seems you hold the key to our salvation.
Good to know. Here I thought we'd be ass deep in demons forever.
Dang. Barrack that chest hair.
Rogue, storyteller, and occasionally unwelcome tag along.
Are you with the Chantry, or...?
Was that a serious question?
Technically, I'm a prisoner, just like you.
I brought you here to tell your story to the Divine. Clearly, that is no longer necessary.
Yet, here I am. Lucky for you, considering current events.
So I closed the rift. What now?
Now we go to meet Leliana.
What a great idea!
Absolutely not. Your help is appreciated, Varric, but...
Have you been in the valley lately, Seeker? Your soldiers aren't in control anymore. You need me.
Yeah. You need me. I win.
My name is Solus, if there are to be introductions. I am pleased to see you still live.
He means I kept that mark from killing you while you slept.
You seem to know a great deal about it all.
Solus is an apostate, well-versed in such matters.
Technically, all mages are now apostates, Cassandra. My travels have allowed me to learn much of the Fade, far beyond the experience of any Circle mage. I came to offer whatever help I can give with the breach. If it is not closed, we are all doomed, regardless of origin.
Alright. Well...
And what will you do once this is over?
One hopes those in power will remember who helped, and who did not.
He slightly approves. Oh no.
You should know. The magic involved here is unlike any I've seen. Your prisoner is no mage. Indeed, I find it difficult to imagine any mage having such power.
Understood. We must get to the forward camp quickly.
Well... Bianca's excited.
Secrets?
This way, down the bank.
Secrets?
The road ahead is blocked.
We must move quickly.
Secrets? Woo! Watch out. Get out of my way. Secrets? Oh, good God. Well, let's be this guy.
Demons ahead.
Glad you brought me now, Seeker.
On tactic camera, use left stick to scan the battlefield. Use R to cycle through targets. To order issues. Okay. Alright, so... attack. Wait, okay, so we can just attack? Huh. This is kind of cool. What is switching, like, don't I just want to focus fire, basically, though? Like, these are, everybody's attacking that one guy, right? Isn't that probably good? Also, this is a little loud. Now I can switch and be like, kill this. Oops. Okay, that's dead. Is there another bad guy? I don't think there's another bad guy. Exit. Huh. Well, you're not attacking because you're busy planifying. You have to switch characters. I didn't have to, though. It seemed like everybody... secrets? Fire is the secret. I mostly use tactical cam to coordinate revives. Interesting.
So, are you innocent?
I don't remember what happened.
That'll get you every time. Should have spun a story.
That's what you would have done.
It's more believable.
Did I miss loot? No! You can't miss loot. Wait, searching? How do you search? What's my rarest card? What? More loot. Oh, rarest magic card? Probably book promo Jace. Ooh. Woohoo! Gathered resources. The loot is on fire. I don't see a sword. I think you guys are trolling me about this whole sword thing. Although I like this loot feature. That's kind of cool. If you just Google book promo Jace, you'll know what I'm talking about. Is there loot this way? Oh, I found it. More elf root. I feel like I'm getting trolled, but I'm gonna go look anyways. You gotta jump in the fire 50 times to get your secret quest. Ooh, hey. Oh god. Huh. Alright, so we all... Holy crap! Okay, so if I do that... I don't know how much it's worth right now. You have to... No, it's dead.
You are Danish, but clearly away from the rest of your clan. Did they send you here?
What do you know of the Dalish?
I have wandered many roads in my time, and crossed paths with your people on more than one occasion.
Woohoo! Iron!
What do you mean by crossed paths?
I mean that I offer to share knowledge, only to be attacked for no greater reason than their superstition.
Can't you elves just play nice for once?
Alright, well, I came here. What did I get? Where's my inventory? Whoopsies. I got a life ward amulet. What does it do? Examine. 50. All right. Neat. Alright. Okay, I got a cool amulet. Neat. What time is it? 11:45, eh? Alright, sounds good. Are the subtitles wrong? Oh, hold on. Options. Audio. There we go. There we go. Ow. Dominated. Yeah, the music in this game is super good.
Another rift!
We must seal it! Quickly! They keep coming! Help us!
I'm gonna get it. Did I get it? Boom! Dominated. Woohoo! Character leveled up! Obviously, James will romance Iron D. Yeah, I have no idea who I'm gonna romance. Alright, your character is leveled up. This increases your health and stats automatically and awards you one ability point to use. Press this. Close. Alright. One point to spend. Double daggers, archery, sabotage. Well, I mean, we're just gonna go into daggers. Active abilities have a diamond shaped. Upgrades. Passive abilities have circular icons. Alright. When you have an ability points available, press A to learn a highlighted ability. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, that seems sure. Okay, yeah, I get it. You fire a powerful single shot, delivers more. Okay, so what's. Do more damage when firing from elevation. You learn to pick apart enemies that are still wounded and unwary. You do more damage to enemies that are only lightly injured. Interesting. Game bad? No! Alright, kind of feel like taking a long shot, but probably death from above. Well, what do you guys think? Kind of want to just take the long shot. Did it. Okay. Oh. There we go. Wait. Do I have another point to spend? All right. All right, there we go. Figured it out. Oh, I already have long shot. Okay.
Rift is gone. Open the gate.
Right away, Lady Cassandra.
We are clear for the moment.
Right, so I've put long shot on both
whatever
X and B
on
now.
Your hand is, it's useful.
All right.
Here they come.
You made it. Chancellor Roderick, this is...
I know who she is. As Grand Chancellor of the Chantry, I hereby order you to take this criminal to Valroyo to face execution.
Hey!
Order me? You are a glorified clerk, a bureaucrat.
And you are a thug, but a thug who supposedly serves the Chantry.
Chantry.
We serve the Most Holy, Chancellor. As you well know.
Justinia is dead. We must elect a replacement and obey her orders on the matter.
So none of you are actually in charge here.
You killed everyone who was in charge.
It was an accident.
Or a retreat, Seeker. Our position here is hopeless.
I didn't
we
mean to.
We can stop this before it's too late.
How? You won't survive long enough to reach the temple, even with all your soldiers.
We must get to the temple. It's the quickest
get route. To the chopper.
But not the safest. Our forces can charge as a distraction while we go through the mountains.
We lost contact with an entire squad on that path. It's too risky.
Listen, too risky.
Abandon this now, before more lives are lost.
How do you think we should proceed?
Ooh!
Now you're asking me what I think.
You have the mark.
And you are the one we must keep alive. Since we cannot agree on our own.
Wait, what?
Use the mountain path. Work together. You all know what's at stake.
Liliana, bring everyone left in the valley. Everyone.
On your head be the consequences, Seeker.
He seems like a nice guy. Or a douche. I don't know. I'm still making up my mind. I'm actually leaning more towards douche. Hey, it's like Lord of the Rings now. We're a fellowship of four. No, the mountain path is blocked. You must go through the mines. That's what's gonna happen, isn't it? We're gonna go through the mines, and then we're gonna come out, and we're gonna have to go to Moria. I would like to climb. Whoa, I just don't stop. One button, go.
The tunnel should be just ahead. The path to the temple lies just beyond it.
What manner of tunnel is this? A mine?
Part of an old mining complex.
Oh, goddammit.
Mountains are full of such paths.
And your missing soldiers are in there somewhere?
Along with whatever has detained them.
We shall see soon enough.
Was it Gandalf? It was Gandalf, wasn't it? Get in there, you stupid wizard. It's a good thing I have literally every arrow known to man. Alright. Man, I remember back in the day in WoW when you actually had to, like, you had to have arrows and ammunition. Holy moly. That was crazy. Alright. You have infinite arrows in this game. Smoke bomb. Ooh, loot. Sick. Ooh, Ooh, more loot. Bad guys are up there. Got some gold. All right. Ow. Go fuck yourself. Hey, you big jerk. Have I ever played Monster Hunter? I've played a little bit. I have Monster Hunter for my 3DS XL. Oh wait, there was a new... Oh shit, the new WoW expansion was released, wasn't it? I know actually nothing about that. I should look into it. Or was it? I know I needed a melee map. Didn't I just get one? Inventory. Weapons. There we go. No, I can't. It's two-handed, so I can't have one. Not announced. I don't mean released. Sorry. My bad. Who uses... World of Warcraft Legion? I'll look it up when I'm on lunch. Alright. Ooh. Alright. Oh, it's coming out this year? Holy shit. Kind of, let's heads down, go. I only have like half an hour before I need to kind of get out of here, so. Cover me while I disrupt this rift. Didn't I just kill you? Wah! Oh, you're new and creepy looking. Yeah, the animations on the rift closing are pretty sweet.
You are becoming quite proficient at this.
It is as just as easy as holding down the A button.
Thank the Maker you finally arrived, Lady Cassandra. I don't think we could have held out much longer.
Thank our prisoner, Lieutenant. She insisted we come this way.
The prisoner? Then you...
We have to get to the breach, and quickly.
To the breach? I don't...
The way into the valley behind us is clear for the moment. Go, while you still can.
At once. Quickly, let's move!
Wait, what? Why don't you guys come with us?
The path ahead appears to be clear of demons as well.
Let's hurry before that changes. Down the ladder. That's the way to the temple.
Blizzard, or Warlords didn't do very well. Blizzard is stepping up development on a bunch of properties to compensate. Look. Ooh, crap! Jesus. What? Climb down, you stupid. Okay, Jesus Christ. I mean, WoW is so old, so.
Accidentally happen, right?
If enough magic is brought to bear, it is possible.
But there are easier ways to make things explode.
That is true.
That is
true. We'll consider how this happened once the immediate danger is past.
The Temple of Sacred Ashes.
What's left of it?
That is where you walked out of the Fade.
Creepy.
They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one knows who she was.
Dear God. Fall damage hype. I'll start playing Minecraft probably September, late September, early October is when I will get back to Minecraft. To be honest, at this point, depending on if I really get into this game, probably after this game. I'm a little excited for the next Minecraft update. I mean, we play mostly,
here. Thank the maker.
Modded, so...
Eliana, have your men take up positions around the temple.
The Intelligentleman with that 14-month resub! Thank you so much for your continued support of the channel. Super appreciate it.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'm assuming you have a plan to get me up there.
No. This rift was the first, and it is the key. Seal it, and perhaps we seal the breach.
Then let's find a way down, and be careful.
I can jump really high.
Now is the hour of our victory.
What?
Bring forth the sacrifice.
What? No. No
what
sacrifice.
Are we hearing?
At a guess. Person who created the breach.
You know this stuff is red lyrium, Seeker.
I see it, Varric.
But what's it doing here?
Magic could have drawn on lyrium beneath the temple, corrupted it.
It's evil. Whatever you do, don't touch it.
Do I literally just have to jump down there? Oh, no, there we go. Walk 5 more feet. Find stairs.
That is Divine Justinia's voice.
Ooh, that was a nice transition.
Someone help me!
What's going on here?
That was your voice. Most holy called out to you, but...
Ah! Dear God.
What's going on here?
Run while you can! Hold them!
We have an intruder. Slay the elf.
No! Don't slay the elf. The elf's cool.
You were there. Who attacked? And the divine, is she? Was this vision true? What are we seeing?
I don't remember.
Echoes of what happened here. The fate bleeds into this place. This rift is not sealed.
Hello, hello, hello. What's all this then?
Albeit temporarily. I believe that with the mark, the rift can be opened and then sealed properly and safely. However, opening the rift will likely attract attention from the other side.
That means demons! Stand ready!
Stand ready! These guys are like, oh man. Chesthere McGee is all like, yeah, yeah, let's do this. I'll just stand here while you guys fight. Holy crap! Whoa! That is a sick laugh.
We must strip its defenses. Wear it down.
Can I disrupt the rift?
The demon is vulnerable. Now!
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Go again, go again, go again. Nope. Hey, what? There it goes.
More coming through the rift.
Ah! Seriously, is this demon not enough? Combat looks really bad. I really like it. Low health. Oh no. Ow. That's surprising. I really enjoy this combat system. Uh-oh. I mean, I don't know what the combat was like in the other game, so...
Now, seal the rift.
I'm trying. Wait, what? I'm trying. There it goes. Ugh.
Do it.
Hooray! Did it. Talk often to your do do do. Cutscene. Chivo get. Hey, I'm all undressed now. Where'd all my armor go?
Awake, I swear.
Is this another prison?
I don't think so.
Then where am I? Tell me.
I beg your forgiveness and your blessing. I am but a humble servant. You are back in Haven, my lady. They say you saved us. The breach stopped growing, just like the mark on your hand. It's all anyone has talked about for the last 3 days.
Then the danger is over.
The breach is still in the sky, but that's what they say. I'm certain Lady Cassandra would want to know you've wakened. She said, at once.
And where is she?
In the Chantry, with the Lord Chancellor. At once, she said.
I'm not entirely sure I'm sold on this woman. Oh, there we go. The outfit was like, woohoo, take all. Ooh, I'll read this. Vain hope. Someone better at this point. Someone better at this than me before the service. No, okay, day one. Climby, shallow breathing, pulse over fast, not responsive, pupils dilated, mage scissor scarring, mark is thrumming with unknown magic. Wish we could station a Templar in here just in case. Jerks. Ho! Hi. Hi, everybody.
That's the Herald of Andraste. They said when she came out of the Fade, Andraste herself was watching over her.
Alright. Let's go, go, go.
That's her.
Ooh.
She's not the breach from getting any bigger.
I heard she was supposed to close it entirely.
No.
Still, it's more than anyone else has done.
Yeah, fuck you. What have you done? I closed the goddamn breach. What's in here? Read. Less thrashing. Some response to stimulus. Vital seems solid. Hooray! Wait, did that just say somebody tried to break in and kill me? I can't read that again. Oh well.
Good luck sealing those rifts.
Thanks. Appreciate it. Secret, secret, secrets. Put them in my mouth. Loot! Give me the loot! Ooh, apprentice armor. Neat. Oh god, this is gonna be one of those lots to read things. I generally don't do the whole reading thing in these kind of games. That just takes too long, especially on the in stream. All right. Secret, secret, secrets. Put them in my mouth. All right, where am I going? Let's actually go to where I'm supposed to go here.
Chain her! I want her prepared for travel to the capital for trial.
Disregard that and leave us.
You walk a dangerous line, Seeker.
The breach is stable, but it is still a threat. I will not ignore it.
Let me guess. You need my help.
You have done plenty. Your actions will be taken into account by the new divine.
Have a care, Chancellor. The breach is not the only threat we face.
Someone was behind the explosion at the Conclave. Someone most holy did not expect. Perhaps they died with the others, or have allies who yet live.
I am a suspect?
You, and many others.
Yeah.
But not the prisoner.
I heard the voices in the temple. The divine called to her for help.
So her survival, that thing on her hand, all a coincidence.
Providence. The Maker sent her to us in our darkest hour.
The breach is stable now. What more do you want from me?
We must try again.
The breach remains, and your mark is still our only hope of closing it.
This is not for you to decide.
You
know what this is, Chancellor.
It's a book.
A writ from the divine, granting us the authority to act. As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn.
Inquisition!
We will close the breach, we will find those responsible, and we will restore order with or without your approval.
Damn. Yeah. Get fucked.
This is the Divine's directive. Rebuild the Inquisition of old. Find those who will stand against the chaos. We aren't ready. We have no leader. No numbers. And now, no Chantry support.
But we have no choice. We must act now. With you at our side.
What is the Inquisition of old, exactly?
It preceded the Chantry. People who banded together to restore order in a world gone mad.
After? They laid down their banner and formed the Templar Order, but the Templars have lost their way. We need those who can do what must be done, united under a single banner once more.
But aren't you still part of the Chantry?
Is that what you see?
The Chantry will take time to find a new divine, and then it will wait for her direction.
What up, Lurontarian?
We cannot wait. So many grand clerics died at the Conclave. No, we are on our own. Perhaps forever.
Sure.
What if I refuse?
You can go if you wish.
You should know that while some believe you chosen, many still think you guilty. The Inquisition can only protect you if you are with us.
We can also help you.
It will not be easy if you stay. But you cannot pretend this has not changed you.
I agree for now.
We'll see how this goes.
That is all we ask.
Help us fix this before it's too late.
That was the weird... Why did she not... She shook her hand, but then she didn't... Her thumb was just sitting there. You don't do that. You shake and you... okay, whatever. This immersion ruins. The book has been read. The birds have been released. Shirtal with that 2-month resubscription. Shirtal, thank you so much for resubscribing to the channel. I really appreciate it. Sub hype indeedly doodly. Send the ravens. What does this say? I don't know what that means. I see a dragon on it, though. And this guy's probably pretty angry. Can I romance her, by the way? Is that an option? Cause, damn. She's pretty fucking badass. And I'm not even joking, but that will probably do it for the stream today. So, yeah. Magic starts in 40 minutes, and I need to get lunch. Awkward. I'm sorry, I kind of honestly thought about not playing this game today, just because I knew the stream was going to be a little short, especially when I was running late, and then the internet wasn't working, and then it wasn't streaming properly, so awkward. How about one game of, yeah, huzzah, we did the intro. We'll come back next week and play for a really good 5 hours. Before I go, look at the skill tree and find better than walking. Nope. Oops. 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 All right. Where is it? I don't see anything called better than walking. Ooh. Cool. Under the bow. Circle. What? Under the bow, circle on the bottom left? I see strafing shots. It's in sabotage. Upgrade for the middle school. Oh, it beats walking. You can use hook and tackle with no stamina, cost, or cooldown time. What? That's amazing. Just keep going with this stuff. Alright, back. Oops. Save. New save. Alright. Let's play one very quick game of Rocket League! Yeah, we're gonna play one quick game of Rocket League first. And then I'm gonna go get food. Yeah, we'll be drafting Origins today, obviously. It's a streamer showdown at 1. So we'll definitely be drafting stuff there. All right, Rocket League. Ugh, I did get Origins on this thing. Felt dirty. Library. All right, Rocket League. Okay, I'm done yelling Rocket League now. All right. I feel gross just looking at Origins. Whoa, what? This is not my car. Damn it. People have been screwing with my shit. I haven't actually played Rocket League for a couple of days since I got back from All right. That would be Paul. Oh, I guess yeah. Oh Oh my god, how did I miss that? No! Damn it. Why does your car have a hat? Because you can get hats in this game. No big deal. I didn't see that guy there. That was annoying. Alright. Let's go for it. First touch. Get out. Oh god. One of my teammates isn't doing anything! No! God, I can't believe I missed that. Oh god, oh god, oh god. No! Shit! That's bad. I'm clearly out of practice of this game. Holy shit. Score that goddamn goal. Oh, you suck. Get out. Ow, no! Oh god, no! Yes! Yes! Oh, crap. Oh, god. Oh, god. Get out! Oh, god. No! No! Yes. Get out. Oh god. Oh god. Good job. Okay. Center. Center. Nope. Maybe not. Oh no. Nope. No! Score! Yes! Haha! Sick. Alright. We can get this. We can tie this back up. Well, first. These guys don't like going for the. Oh, shit. No! Okay, good. Get down there. Clear that shit! That was bad. That was bad. Oh my god, I think I just did that to myself. Oh, I totally did. Oh no. Something's wrong with Mikko? Well, that's bad. swear to God, you mother... Come on! No! We need so many goals. Oh God. Oh my God. I swear to God. Guys. Seconds. We can do this. Damn. Damn. Come on. Score. Yes. Yeah. No! No. No! Alright. Alright, guys. That is going to be it for this afternoon, or for this morning, I guess. I guess this is more of a morning thing. Oh, let's exit here. That was good. That was a fun stream. I apologize of it being a little shorter than normal, but we'll be back next week with more Dragon Age, because that game looks pretty sweet. I'm excited to continue to play it. And in the meantime, enjoy a half an hour without any streaming, and then we'll be back for the Magic Online Streamer Showdown for Magic Online Origins. It should be pretty sweet. And I will leave you with some cool music so you aren't sad. And go. All right, guys. We'll see you in a couple minutes.